Hey everybody, stay tuned today where I'm talking to Brian about the operations management baseline and how it can really help you manage your operations in the cloud. Welcome to the Azure Enablement Show. In this show, we're having technical conversations with Microsoft experts about some of the common questions or concerns you might have around your cloud adoption journey. Now, in previous episodes, we talked about how the cloud adoption framework can actually help accelerate your cloud adoption journey. In today's episode, we're focusing on the operations management baseline. And to have that conversation with me, I'm welcoming back Brian to the show. Welcome to the show, Brian.
Hey, Sarah, thanks for having me again.
Now, in the last show, we talked about the operations management baseline, which is part of the cloud adoption framework manage methodology. Why do customers need to think about this baseline, Brian?
So without having a rich baseline in place, operations are at risk. And like we see from the classic Murphy's Law, what can fail eventually will fail. And we have to prepare for that failure in anything that we're operating, whether it's in the cloud or on-prem. So an operations baseline gives us a lot of those IT operations practices that we used on-prem, but brings them forward to the cloud so that we can kind of keep Murphy's Law at bay and make things a little bit more stable.
So I've heard people mention this new product that we have at Azure, the Azure Automanage service. And I believe that can help with the baseline. Is that correct, Brian?
It definitely can. Yeah. So when we look at the principles of what's in an operations baseline, those are three key principles. Let me switch over to a slide deck here. There we go. So inside of any operations baseline, you have things like inventory and visibility for monitoring, operational compliance for making sure things are patched and properly configured and optimized, and a general way to protect and recover your environment. Now, that baseline that we built out inside the Cloud Adoption Framework was then the inspiration for the product that you just mentioned, Azure Automanage. Now, this is not the tool for everyone. It's an opinionated approach to those three things that is able to be deployed with a couple of clicks to be able to give you an automated operations baseline to automate a lot of those protections that we talked about and minimize a lot of those potential outages by making sure that you've got uptime monitoring, you've got patching, you've got automated cost reductions, and you've got a number of security best practices in place. So this really reduces your need to produce your own operations baseline. Now, if that doesn't fit with you, you can build your own. And that's what we'll talk about today.
Awesome. Now, there are system failures, as you mentioned, that's kind of part and parcel of an IT department. Does this operations baseline help you prepare or even prevent those system failures, Brian?
It definitely can. Yeah, but it's not the answer to everything. Just like with AutoManage, this is kind of your starting point. It's the most common denominator that you'll see to reduce risk. So where we see the operations baseline come in is the bulk of your portfolio. So if you're managing hundreds of workloads, you know, a good percentage of them are going to get enough of an SLA between what Azure already provides as a default SLA and the minimum protections that we talk about in the operations baseline. Now, there are other things that you may need that would get into more of the enhanced baseline or more enhancements around a platform or a workload. And we have guidance inside of the Cloud Adoption Framework's managed methodology to guide that. And you'll see the same type of guidance inside of our well-architected framework when you get into the workload operations. But they all stem from the same practices we're going to talk about today that will protect that bulk of your portfolio.
So some of the parts of this baseline are various different parts, and I want to unpack those, Brian. So the inventory and visibility portion of it, what is that and what gets deployed within Azure to help you with this baseline?
So inventory and visibility is our first tactical piece that we deploy. So in this, what we're looking for is making sure that every asset that you have is inventoried and classified, it's monitored, logging's happening the same way. You're really understanding and looking for anything you can do to improve stability, performance, and general operations. So this is how we manage technical change, because change is one of the most common things that will cause those failures. So reporting on and understanding the change is really important. And over on the right, there's a number of tools that you could use to really improve that overall inventory and visibility. The ones we suggest for every single operations baseline are two pretty easy tools. Azure Monitor. So this is going to give you the centralized logs and metrics, alerts and dashboards. It's going to let you set up that core of your operations of giving you visibility across everything that you have. And then extending on Monitor, we suggest using Azure Advisor. So this gives very specific recommendations that you can act on that'll help improve things like reliability, performance, and cost. To really get that visibility, not just on where you are and what's changed, but also what you can do to improve. So those are the first two tools we start with, but there's a whole host of others that you can use to improve that overall monitoring, visibility, and inventory management.
Awesome. So that kind of shows you what's going on and how to respond to changes. What about compliance needs? Lots of organizations have different and varying compliance needs. I'm betting there's a part of the baseline that actually helps answer that for the customer. Is that right?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, that's one of the most important disciplines in the baseline is operational compliance. Because just seeing things is a start, but really where things start to break down is in the actual maintenance. One of the most common causes of any kind of security breach or failure is just basic patching. So update management is a challenge that customers really struggle with when they're managing a portfolio. So we want to make sure that things are patched. We also want to make sure that policies are enforced and that any other compliance requirements are automated to the best of their ability. And using these type of approaches to make sure you've optimized your environment for the maximum performance per cost that you have, and really doing that through configuration of that overall portfolio. So that's the general nature of operational compliance. And this is delivered through two key tools as well. The first being update management, which gives you that ability to automate patching for all of your different assets out there to make sure that you don't run into patching issues. And also cost analysis, which lets you look across your portfolio to identify areas where you really need to optimize operations and reduce costs because maybe you have a bunch of assets that aren't reaching peak utilization and you just want to pull them back a little bit to save some money and really manage your budgets across all of your different workloads.
So what about those system failures and recovering from those system failures, Brian? What does the baseline do for that part of the operations?
Yeah, so no matter what we do with operational compliance and monitoring, Murphy's Law will strike. So we have to prepare for failure. And when failure happens, that's when the protect and recovery discipline really helps out. And the whole thought here is we want to make sure that there's a consistent way to recover everything. And it can be based purely on Azure backup. That's generally what we see for most customers is making sure that you've just got sound backups all in one location that you can recover from in case of failure. But we also include other things like Azure Site Recovery, or really when we start to dig into more of those workload level operations or even tech platform operations, we start to look at active failovers so that we can use multiple different environments and recover across multiple locations. So that can be done through site recovery or modifications to the overall architecture. And site recovery, again, is a really big one for making sure that you've got that failover potential if Azure backup isn't quite enough and you need something to respond a little quicker.
The baseline sounds great, Brian, but again, I'm thinking to workloads and organizations that might need more than the baseline. If that's not enough, the baseline, how do you add to it, or can you even add to this baseline?
Yeah, absolutely. So everything that we talk about inside of the managed methodology builds on the baseline. It's also built with the intent on refining these things into various different degrees of operations or using complementary frameworks like the well-architected framework to get into workload operations. So we start with the baseline. We secure the vast majority of your portfolio. And then we start to evaluate what needs more of an enhanced baseline in a particular subscription. What needs more specific platform operations from central IT? And what needs workload operations that may have dedicated staff just to that workload? And all of this guidance that we're talking about inside the operations baseline establishes those disciplines that'll scale out into all of these different directions. So starting here is a great way to move forward with those richer operational needs.
Awesome. That sounds really good, Brian. In terms of if I wanted to get started with my operations baseline today, is there somewhere I can go and head to get some more information and guidance to start it?
Yeah, we can provide a link in the commentary below, but inside of the Cloud Adoption Framework's managed methodology, there's an Azure Server Management Best Practice Guide. You can follow that guide and build out your own operations baseline. And if you follow that guide the way it looks today, you'll end up with a product very similar to Automanage, like you talked about earlier. We suggest using that as a starting point. There's additional best practices in that methodology that you can use to extend that or customize that to fit your own unique needs.
Awesome. Thank you again, Brian, for walking me through this baseline. I really do appreciate your time. And thank you to everybody that's tuned into the show as well. As Brian said, we'll be posting more information in the description box below. So make sure you head there and also stay tuned for future episodes of the Azure Enablement Show.